गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू विज्ञान चिंतन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम क्लास 9th साइंस चैप्टर 10 ग्रेविटेशन। ओके, दिस क्वेश्चन इज टेकन फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज, क्वेश्चन नंबर इज 3। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दिस क्वेश्चन, आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू प्लीज वॉच द एंटायर वीडियो विद केयर, दैट्स व्हाई यू लर्न ऑल अबाउट दिस वीडियो। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। व्हाट इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स बिटवीन द अर्थ एंड 1 kg ऑब्जेक्ट ऑन इट्स सर्फेस? मास ऑफ द अर्थ इज 6 × 10⁴ kg एंड द रेडियस ऑफ अर्थ इज 6.4 × 10⁶ meter। ओके, सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन द वैल्यूज गिवन, फर्स्ट थिंग इज स्मॉल m। स्मॉल m इज व्हाट? मास ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट। व्हाट? मास ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट। हियर 1 kg ऑब्जेक्ट। व्हाट? 1 kg ऑब्जेक्ट। समटाइम्स मास इज नॉट रिटन इन द क्वेश्चन, सो वी गेस बाय लुकिंग kg। ओके, वी गेस बाय लुकिंग kg दैट इट इज अ मास, बिकॉज kg इज द यूनिट ऑफ मास। सो इट इज द मास ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट विच इज इक्वल टू 1 kg। मास ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई स्मॉल m, सो दैट इज 1 kg। एंड हियर इज मास ऑफ द अर्थ, सो मास ऑफ द अर्थ इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाई कैपिटल m, which is equal to 6 × 10⁴ kg. This is the radius of the earth. Radius of the earth is represented by capital R, which is given 6.4 × 10⁶ meter. Let capital G. Capital G is the universal gravitation. Okay. So this is equal to 6.7 × 10⁻¹⁰ newton meter square per kg square. The first thing which is notable, you always write the unit of the quantities like kg, meter, newton, meter square per kg square. Okay. Before going to start any numerical to solve it, the first thing identify by all is what is need to find out in these questions. The need is magnitude of gravitational force. Okay. So by using formula, the formula is F is equal to capital G into capital M into small m upon R square. Okay. I first discuss you. This is magnitude of force. This is universal gravitation. This is mass of earth, mass of object, radius of earth. Okay. Now it's time to substitute the value. F is equal to 6.7 × 10⁻¹⁰ 6 × 10⁴ into 1 over 6.4 × 10⁶ whole square. In this case, you always write 10⁻¹⁰ in one side. Okay. How? 6.7 × 1 × 10⁻¹⁰ × 10⁻¹⁰ When we square up this term, then it can be write as 6.4 × 6.4 ×. When we multiply power with power, power is multiplied. Okay. So 10⁶ × 12. 6 × 2 multiply. So 12. How? If you write a raised to the power m raised to the power n, then you find a raised to the power m into n. So in this case, power power will multiply. Okay. So that's why we multiply 6 × 12 and find here 10⁻¹⁰. After that, I multiply all these. So I do rough here. 6.7 × 6. 6 × 7 = 42, 4 carry. 6 × 6 = 36 + 4 = 40. And after one digit, I apply decimal. Okay. So here 40.2. Okay. Now I multiply 6.4 × 6.4 like this. 4 × 4 = 16, 1 carry. 4 × 6 = 24, 25. 6 × 4 = 24, 2 carry. 6 × 36 + 238. So here I write 6, 549, 8 × 10 = 1 carry, 314. We observe here, there is two digit after decimal, 1, 2. So from this side, 1, 2, I apply here decimal. So our multiplication will be 40.96. Okay. Now I write 10⁻¹⁰ × 10⁻¹⁰. Now this 10⁻¹⁰ goes into numerator, become 10⁻¹⁰. How? If we write here 1 upon a raised to the power m, it become a raised to the power minus m. So that's why I write 10⁻¹⁰ a is equal to 10 to the power minus 12. Okay, now it's time to solve it. So there is a decimal and there is also decimal, and this is one digit, this is two digit. So I multiply by 100. Okay, so 40.2 into 100 over 40.96 into 100. You know, if x raised to the power a into x raised to the power b into x raised to the power c, it become x raised to the power a plus b plus c. It is the case of power and exponent. So that's why I write here 10 raised to the power 24 and minus 11 minus 12. So now when I multiply, I find 4020 upon 4096 into this become 10 to the power 24 minus 2 plus 1 3, 1 plus 1 2. Okay, 24 minus. So finally I divide it by 2, both numerator and denominator. 2 to the 4, 2 0 0, 2 1 the 2, 2 0 0, 2 to the 4, 2 0 0, 2 4 the 8, 2 8 the 16. And here it will become 10 to the power 1, because 24 minus 23 become 1. Now further I divide by 2, and 10 to the power 1 means 10. So 2 1 the 2, 2 0 0, 2 to the 4, 2 4 the 8. And 2 1 the 2, 2 0 0, 2 0 0, 2 5 the 10. And when we multiply by this, 10 become 0. So it will further divide by 2, 2 5 the 10, 2 0 0, 2 2 the 4, 2 5 the 10. And further it divide by 2, 2 5 the 10, 2 1 the 2, 2 2 the 4. Till here you write down or take a screenshot of all these. Now further we cannot divide this directly. So I use common method where 5025 is divided by 512. So this is 502 is less than 512. So I take 4 digit and try to multiply by 9 in 512. So when we multiply by 9 in 512, we find 9 to the 18, 1 carry, 9 1 the 9 1 10, 1 carry, 9 5 the 45, 1 46. And after subtracting, I find this take a carry from this and become 15. 15 minus 8 become 7. 1 minus 0 become 1. And this take carry from 5 become 10. 10 minus 6 become 4. And there is 0. So now this is 417. Is less than 512. So I apply here decimal and place a 0 here. So I take it 8 times. 8 to the 16, 1 carry. 8 1 ja 8, 1 9. 8 5 ja 40. After subtracting, I find 10 minus 6 become 4, 16 minus 9 become 7, and 0 minus 0 become 0, 4 minus 4 become 0. Because of this decimal, I apply here 1 0. So after that, I take it 1 times, 512, and 10 minus 2 become 8, 3 minus 1 become 2, 6 minus 5 become 1. But we calculate 2 digit after decimal, so there is no need to further calculation. So finally we write as force is equal to 9.81 Newton, or we can further say 9.8 Newton. Okay, 9.8 Newton. This will be our magnitude of gravitational force. So further we can write the answer, the magnitude of gravitational force is 9.8 Newton. This will be our answer. Thus the magnitude of gravitational force is 9.8 Newton. Okay, this will be our answer. You take a screenshot or write down it. I hope guys this session will help you for you. If you something learn from it, you like the video, share your friends and subscribe it also. If you have any query, please write down us. Okay, I meet you with the next question in the next video. Till then, bye.